The 2020 Nebraska Book Awards will honor authors and publishers of books with a Nebraska connection published in 2019. The award for cover design and illustration goes to a book that provides a firsthand account of game day in Lincoln, offering an in-depth look at where the Cornhusker fans' spirit began and how it evolved to today's game day experience. The winner is The Spirit of Nebraska, a history of Husker game day traditions, the tunnel walk, mascots, cheer, and more by Deborah Cleve White. Designed by Concierge Marketing and Publishing Services. Published by Cheerful Books.
Hi everyone, I'm Deborah Cleve White, the author of The Spirit of Nebraska, a history of Husker game day traditions, the tunnel walk, mascots, cheer, and more. I would like to thank the Nebraska Center for the Book for awarding my book Best Cover, Design, and Illustrations. I'm honored of the recognition my book received. Also, I would like to thank Lisa Pelto and her staff at Concierge Marketing and Publishing for their creative work and talent working on the book design. It was an incredible experience working with all of them. My book documents the history of UNL game day, including football, Yell Squad, the Scarlets, the band, and the mascots, just to name a few. Did you know the first UNL cheer was created in 1889? And on page 131 of my book, there is a QR code next to a picture of a record. When you scan the QR code with your smartphone, it will take you to a link to play the record. And it is a performance of the first 1889 cheer. I was inspired to write my book from my years of being on the UNL Yell Squad, my love for the organization, and my research to give back to the squad. Also, I wanted to share this information with the Cornhusker fans, and I thought a book would be the perfect way to do that. I would like to do a reading from the book, and to set the stage, it's a train ride that takes place on April 12, 1889 to a baseball game between Doan College and UNL. And the 1889 cheer will be performed for the first time at a sporting event. The special train was crowded with students whose capacity for noise was unlimited. The brass band, the ball club, the university yell, Frank Manley and H.C. Peterson were on board. We needed the band. The yell was attached to Manley, or rather Manley was attached to the yell. And we were bound to Scoot Doan with either the ball club or Peterson, or with both. The train started. The students were jubilant. It was 20 miles from Lincoln to Crete, but the students' melody could be heard in Crete long before the students arrived. Every few moments, some enthusiastic student would arise in their seat and a regular war whoop would follow. We arrived at Crete. Doan students received us with a brass band. The UNIs crowded on the platform and Manley was heard. Now then, one, two, three, yell. And 200 students yelled. You, UNI, ver, versatile, N-E, brass ski. Oh my. Crete stood amazed. The earth reeled. The yell was initiated. Again, thank you everyone for this honor.